A pneumatic blood cannon allows you to fire a sudden burst of blood using just air power. I built this one on wheels so that it can be moved around backstage and put into place right before it's needed in its seat. These are often used to simulate headshot wounds or any other sort of gunshot wound where a sudden blast of blood is needed. This one needs to be plugged in backstage, but it could very easily be switched over to run off of a 12-volt battery, which can sit right down next to the air compressor on the little wagon that the whole thing moves on. An air compressor lives on the bottom of the blood cannon. It's charged up to about 100 PSI before the show, and then it's switched off and unplugged so that it doesn't accidentally trigger during the show. As an added safety feature, I stuck a ball valve right on the end of the air compressor. If you accidentally trigger the blood cannon before it's ready, before it's moved into position, there's no air in the actual system. You can wait until right before you're ready to trigger the device and flip the ball switch to the on position. The air hose goes from the compressor on up the device to two pneumatic solenoid valves. Each valve is run on 12 volts of power. The valves are wired to these two switches on the control panel. One switch controls one cannon, the other controls the other cannon. As an additional safety feature, the switches run to this power strip. So if you flip the switches, when the power strip is off, nothing happens. It's not until you turn the power strip on that the switches are ready to go. From the pneumatic solenoid valves, the air continues up through these clear hoses and attached to these PVC barrels. The barrels of the blood cannon are just a small length of PVC pipe. The nozzles are an end cap with a hole drilled in it. Each end is sealed with a piece of plastic that's cut from a basic plastic shopping bag. The cannon is filled to the very top. When the barrel is full, a second piece of plastic is placed on the other end, and it's attached to the blood cannon securely. Now the PVC runs up so that after the cannon is fired, any extra blood in it will not run down into the cannon works. The whole thing is very easy to clean just by taking these pieces off. All right, I got my air tank full. I got my ball valve switched. I have my thing ready to go. Let's fire this off and see what happens. Two perfect blood splatters.